Hello, everybody, what's going on? This is Will here, we're back with another episode of Banjo-Kazooie. In the last episode, we 100%ed Clanker's Cavern and realized that, I still had to go get the notes from Treasure Trove Cove, because apparently I missed three of them. But I was too lazy to do that between episodes, so I'll do it between these episodes, I guess. We're back in the Clanker's Cavern, entrance area, and we're going to go through this little hole that I unlocked, when I removed the little metal screen door thing there. And we're gonna go and unlock the next world. Why? Because we can. Because we have to. We have to save our sister. It's gotta be done. We're gonna press the Z button, do everything all at once. We got the freaky crocodile face staring back at us. And hey, we opened up a mushroom made of wood? I don't know. But hey, it looks like we opened up the fourth world, which appeared to be called Bubblegloop Swamp. Pretty cool level. I mean, like, I don't know. It's like, it's in the middle for me. It's nostalgic for me for whatever reason. More so than the other levels. No, the next level is probably the most... The next level and the eighth level are probably the most nostalgic for me personally, but that's just because they're my favorite levels. But this one's pretty cool too. It's got a cool, like, I was gonna say conservation. Transformation. Oh yeah, we gotta unlock this. It's got a cool transformation, it's got a mostly pointless, but still useful in its own little way power-up. Or a new move to learn. Only one move to learn in the next three levels, then we have all the moves in the game, actually. But we'll worry about that later. Got into a new area here. The big, ugly statue of Grunty. Yeah, looking good, you old bag. God, you're so ugly looking. We got this big creepy fish thing over here. I don't quite know. He's a big piranha. Just like with Snacker, you can poop eggs on him and kill him. I'm pretty sure. Oh, okay. Well, he hurt me somehow. All right, well, I can't seem to hurt him because I fail. So I won't waste my eggs trying. There are two different ways you can go in this area. You can go over there. But that takes you to the next two worlds, which we can't get to yet. What you want to do is talent trot your way up this big hill. This big, big hill. And go down this... whatever this is. It's a... I think it's supposed to be a log, but that's a pretty... It's a pretty finely chiseled log. No rough grain or anything. It's pretty... pretty good-looking wood. Unlike the actual entrance to the world, which looks awful. Yeah, you fall in the water around here, and as you can see, it's piranha water. So the piranhas will nip and bite at your feet if you go into it, which makes a lot of the areas of this level, Bubblegloop Swamp, very dangerous to walk in. Keep your eyes open for your new move. Yeah, beak face. So there's a good clue already. Although there's not many moves for Banjo as is, this is indeed a move for Kazooie. Yeah, we're gonna walk over and get it. And bottles will teach us how to, yeah, use these cool new power-ups called wading boots. Or wading boots, however you want to say it. And basically what these big boots let you do is they let you walk around in dangerous terrain. Dangerous substances, I suppose. First thing you want to do, though, is walk over to this alligator made of metal, I guess. And you want to shoot an egg into his mouth when his mouth's open. Mmm, yummy! Croc dislike eggs! Alright. So what you have to do is you have to follow this guy throughout the whole level, and his eyes will change color each time. Or I think they're supposed to be like different alligators, I guess. But they'll pop up at different points of the level, and you just have to feed them all an egg, and you get a jiggy from it. Which is pretty cool. You can go over there and try out the wading boots right now. And what they do is they make Kazooie's feet really long! And, well, you can just wade around in all the dangerous substances without getting hurt. But they only last a certain amount of time, so you want to watch yourself. Oop. Yeah, as you can see. Oop, okay. Well, there we go. You can just press the B button anytime, too, and you can get rid of the power-up. So that's pretty useful, too. So, we're gonna go and grab our first Jinjo, which is pretty obviously placed. Jinjos in this area are actually pretty easy. There we go. This level is really just like getting you used to environmental hazards in the level, because I'm pretty sure every level from here on out has, like, some kind of dangerous water you walk in. Ooh. I'm pretty sure. Yeah, okay, we'll do this jiggy first. Push down this, and a jiggy will pop up at the end of this long, narrowing, narrow winding, there we go, pathway, and you just gotta get it in time. It's pretty easy, actually. They give you a lot of time, so it's pretty, generous. Don't worry about grabbing every note on your way up, like, you know, like, if you're a bit worried, just make it your first, priority getting the jiggy. But, you can use the R button, of course, and put the camera behind Banjo at all times. So using your double jump, or like your double fluttery jumpy thing, whatever it's called, in tandem with your camera, with the R button, it's actually a really easy jiggy to get. You don't even need to have that good of a controller to do it. It is actually a lot simpler than it looks. Well, or a lot simpler than in typical practice, I suppose. Eh. Yeah. That is one thing you gotta watch out for in the level, though. You don't want to stay in... Ugh, gosh. You don't want to stay in this stuff too long, because it will kill you pretty quickly. Alright, let's get back up here. We gotta pick up some leftover notes, and, pretty sure there's a Mumbo token and another one of the crocodile guys that I missed. Alright. And as you can see, they also get a little bit faster each time you get to the next one. Their mouths open and close a little bit faster. So you gotta get used to that. It's a lot like, I guess it's a lot like Juju from the first level in Mumbo's Mountain, where, the different layers of Juju all, like, spun around at different speeds, and you had to, you know, spit the eggs in their mouths. It's kind of the same concept, except a bit more widespread, I suppose. This is a jiggy that's really easy to get, because all you have to do is just kill a bunch of these frogs. And really, the only, challenge with them, the only real visible challenge is that they take a couple more hits to kill than your average enemy. I think they take twice as many hits. That's what it looks like right now. Yeah, just two hits each time. Really? Rat-a-tat-rap? Or rat-a-tat-tap? I forget what they're called. I forget what a lot of these moves are called. Jeez. Maybe I should have done the tutorial. Just so that I knew all the names of the moves. Okay. God. Sometimes the problem is just getting over to them. Oh, okay. I didn't even hit him with anything, but okay. I literally clicked no buttons. I jumped at the frog and I killed him. Come on. Oh, you. Okay, come on. Oh, God. Just the way they hop around. They can evade moves so easily. There we go. Blob, you killed us. Yeah. Here, have my golden shiny thing. Da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da. Alright. Alright, there's two jiggies already. Wow. Not too bad. What time are we at, anyway? Well, we're still got a little bit of, stuff to do with the time wrap, but that's fine. That just means we can sit back and love this game even more. Just, that's all it means. Fantastic. No, we won't go over there yet. What we should do is probably follow the order of the, those metal crocodiles or whatever. We'll go to this area next. Just like with Clanker's Cavern, this place is split up into multiple polygonal rooms, but again, each polygonal room has specific tasks for you to do that are very easy to notice and see. So yet again, you know, the game isn't too hard yet, but it's really just the game itself is getting a bit more challenging, not so much the landscape yet. Alright, there we go. Push down the Gruntilda switch. And whoa! Oh my gosh! The big statue in the room there! Jeez, the whole top of Grunty's ugly, nasty hat disappeared. There's all these shock jump discs. There we go. Alright, and as we can see, there's another crocodile over there, so we'll have to grab him. Ooh! Okay. Make sure to grab all your ecombokums in this level, too. You know, there's a transformation in this level, so you'll be running low on Mumbo tokens again if you don't pick them up in this level. And I believe this is the jiggy. Okay. There's a lot of the jiggies in this level are actually easy to get. Which is pretty nice. Whereas Clanker's Cavern, like, you know, things were a bit more slow-paced and, clunky just because of all the water navigation. So it's nice to be back on land, you know? It's nice to be back. On the land. On the land. Alright, come on. What is... Okay, we don't have to do this part yet, I don't think. Ooh, my feet are so numb and cold. Yeah. Well, we can't help you yet, man. I mean, I guess we could if we wanted to. Okay. We'll do it. We'll help you out, man. This is hilarious. What you have to do is you have to use the beak buster on this poor turtle's fins to force his feet back into his shell. And just listen to him. Oh my god, that's a bit better. Oh, what a relief. That does not sound like you're relieved. Oh man. Banjo-Kazooie is pretty funny with its sounds, but... Oh man. Banjo-Tooie gets way funnier with all the sounds you hear from the characters. Way funnier. I think it's pretty much by then, like, Rare was completely self-aware of how funny and hilarious they were. I was like, who cares, right? Alright, I guess we're gonna go in here next. Ugh. God, I didn't want to do this. This is the only Jiggy I really didn't want to do. Well, no, there's another one I don't like doing, but... Both the mini-games in this level are just really freaking annoying. I'm gonna grab a few notes first here. This is a mini-game called Tip-Tup Choir, and what you have to do is... Tip-Tup here, the turtle, he's going to conduct his little crew to play music in a certain order, and you have to do a beak buster on their head in the right order. And, like, you know, that was pretty easy. Bit short, isn't it? Yeah. And what you have to do, I think there are three different difficulties, I'm pretty sure. Like, look, I already don't remember. Okay. I think it was, yeah, cyan, yellow, magenta, I think. Pretty sure. Yeah, okay. And see, and now the lessons just keep getting a bit more complicated. Cyan, purple, magenta, yellow. Okay. Oh, okay. All right, now back to magenta. Oh, God. Oh, gosh. Okay, let's see if I remember this. Oh, my. I don't think I do. Oh, magenta, yellow, magenta. And it gets more and more stressful because... The sequences just keep getting longer and longer. Just, ugh, freaks me out. I never liked these memorization minigames. Oh gosh. Oh gosh. Oh gosh, I don't think I remember that. Oh no. Oh no. Okay, purple. Oh gosh. I really don't think I remember it at all. That's wrong. Oh, okay. Oh god, now was it blue or was it... Oh god. Was it blue? Oh my god, it wasn't blue, was it? It wasn't blue, was it? Oh. Now it's yellow? Yellow? Now is it blue or red? Oh. Oh god. Oh god! Magnificent, a true masterpiece. Here, take this trinket I found earlier. Yeah, okay. Give me that freaking jiggy! I don't know why I find that minigame so stressful. It's just, ugh. Sorry, there is nothing more I can teach you. Well, that's fine. I don't want to learn anything from you, Tip-Tup. You were never my favorite racer in Diddy Kong Racing. That's actually a true story. I actually never really liked him that much in Diddy Kong Racing. I'm sorry for all you Tip-Tup fans out there. Okay. So now I already have no idea where I'm going. Okay. I think I know. I have to go to this section. I know that you have to go to the big alligator head last. Like, if you just want to do things in a logical order. Pretty sure. Okay, there we go. Because the thing is that you have to backtrack through the whole level again once you transform at Mumbo's Hut in this level. Because there's a bunch of notes and, like, a Jinjo and stuff you can really only get... conveniently get with the transformation. So...